Hello, I'm Cezary Siwek, and I'd like to introduce you to Continuum Rover team from University of Wrocław. Our team consists of 10 people who enjoy doing awesome stuff. Our management is ruled by agile methodology, in which the work is separated into small production cycles, and at the end of every production cycle, we have a meeting in which we discuss our progress, give an instant feedback to each other, and present what we expect to be our working prototypes. Thanks to our experience, we are capable of making pretty good estimations of how much work each cycle will take and how much progress is needed. Taking into account that we have all the milestones already planned, we are sure that we will finish on schedule.
The machine is supported on a rocker bogie suspension with four electric bike engines in wheels, providing enough power to even pull a car. It is equipped with a sophisticated robotic arm that has 5 degrees of freedom and allows us to reach up to 1.3 meters. We have also implemented the inverse kinematics, so we can move the effector automatically to any accessible pole. In order to communicate between the base and the rover, we use the network working on 900 MHz and 2.4 GHz frequencies based on band accessibility. Both those solutions were extensively tested by us and proven to be very reliable.
The rover was designed with modularity in mind. Depending on the requirements, we can change configuration for each task. We can equip the rover with module for retrieving samples, foil probe, plastic box for transporting tools, lighter wheels, Geiger counter, and so on. The arm is also detachable.
The rover is constantly evolving prototype, which is regularly used very intensively. Because of this, many moving elements are prone to wear and need occasional servicing. Examples of this are manipulator tooth belts and mechanical elements of drive system. We are working on making these parts more durable. Now we will introduce you to the recent changes in our rover.
Our first goal is to provide better energy efficiency and more control over batteries and delivered power. So we are testing and developing our custom batteries. We have reduced our system voltage, increased current capabilities, and added possibility of daisy chaining battery models. We are also planning to add some flexibility by providing a choice between reducing battery wear and achieving higher performance per cycle. But as much as we like pushing our equipment to the limits, in power management, safety is our number one priority.
Our second goal is to reduce the amount of wiring and speed up the process of reconfiguration of the rover for each task. Therefore, we introduced communication buses for standardized protocols, power supply and connectors. To reduce the risk of electrical faults, we have provided galvanic isolation for critical points of our buses.
To increase our productivity, we have taken the effort to implement a software system that allows us to easily add sensors. To add a new sensor, we only have to plug a universal board and program it. No further changes of the rover or base software are needed. Our system automatically identifies the board capabilities, organizes communication, and generates user interface.
For the science task, we are conducting a lot of research regarding Martian soil, rocks, and atmosphere. Our study will give us answers about the type of environment and possibility of sustaining any life forms.
We are planning to include complex analysis of the soil samples, and we will perform the qualitative analysis of the regolith elements like carbon, iron, sodium and others to check if the soil is available for planting and what useful elements are in it. Sensors on the rover are optimized to successfully measure properties of the regolith and atmosphere.
Cameras in our rover covers broad range of possible usage scenarios. We have front wide-angle camera to allow comfortable operator-based navigation, one camera on robotic arm to increase performance and precision of rover operations, and another wide-angle camera, a mast, to have good overview of whole platform.
For the purpose of localization, we created a visual odometry unit containing Raspberry Pi microcomputer with a camera facing the ground. Using visual flow information provided by video encoder, we can estimate the exact rotation and movement of the entire rover. Using sensor fusion, we can combine this information with GPS and wheel odometry data for better navigation.
Our another goal is to exploit possibilities of new stereo vision system. We aim to get precise 3D mapping of environment ahead of rover, which will allow us to improve its autonomy level.
All our components are ready now, and before the competition we just have to integrate and field test the new system. We plan to perform two mock competitions in the countryside and additional smaller tests indoors. The future looks good and the weather for outdoor testing is now fantastic. See you in Utah!